Hey boys and girls, I'm so glad to see you again at another craft time with Miss Corrie. Today I thought, in light of our story of duck and goose finding a pumpkin, what could be more appropriate than playing with pumpkins? And one of the first things I thought we should do is actually paint a pumpkin. And painting pumpkins is really easy and it doesn't hurt you because you don't have to use a knife to carve into the pumpkin and take things out and take the seeds out. It's not all messy and goopy, although I will say I do like to carve the pumpkins because then you can get the seeds out and roast them and they're so good. One of the best parts of fall. So either carve a pumpkin with somebody who can help you carve a pumpkin, or maybe you can just paint one. And so of course what you're going to need is going to be pumpkins. And if you stop in at the Herr Memorial Library, we will actually have pumpkins for you. We have little pumpkins like this that are available for you to pick up. And what we'd like you to do is to take it home and paint it or decorate it any way you'd like, and then take a picture of it and then email it to us at her@herlibrary.org. And we will go ahead and post your picture of your decorated pumpkin on our pumpkin patch wall. And so we'd love to have our pumpkin patch full of pictures. So make sure you do that for us. But if you can't make it into the library, you can still email us a picture of your pumpkin. You're just gonna have to provide your own. And you can use little pumpkins or a little bit bigger pumpkins or slightly bigger pumpkins or even bigger pumpkins. And these are an example of one that I've already done. This is one that we gave a beach scene to. We just painted it and decorated it. We used glitter and we used some charms and some shells, and we used some glitter and some shellac for paint, and we used some cookie decoration sugar pellets here to make it look like pearl seeds. And that's our beach painted pumpkin. That turned out really cute. And then we're gonna make another one with you guys today. I've started it, so we'll finish it in this video. So I'm gonna go ahead and move this one off to one side. And we're gonna go ahead and start with our pumpkins. So the first thing you need to do is pick out a pumpkin. It doesn't have to be perfect. It can have scratches and stuff on it. Each pumpkin is unique, so you can make it any way you want. But what you're gonna need to do first is take any stickers off of it that you may have on it. You wanna make sure that you get it completely cleaned off. And then we recommend that you wash and dry your pumpkin thoroughly. That keeps your paint from chipping and flaking off. So go ahead and wash and dry your pumpkin thoroughly. Now, if you use white pumpkins, if you paint them with lighter colors, that'll be easier because you won't have to put a primer color down. But if you're just working with an orange pumpkin and you want to use different colors that are light, like white or yellow, I recommend that you get some spray paint. Just go ahead and get a can of spray paint. Take it outside where there's lots of ventilation and do it on the grass because you can cut the grass and you don't end up spray painting your house. And shake your can up really good and then spray your whole pumpkin until it's nice and white like that. So then for this craft, what I decided we're going to do is we're going to put some paper down first to protect our surfaces. And I got a foamy paintbrush like this. And I got some purple and I got some pink paint. And what I ended up doing, I got a paper plate and I took my pink paint and I poured a little circle of pink paint on there like so. And then I took my purple paint and I dribbled some drops of purple paint directly on top of the white. You don't want to stir it yet. You just want to dribble a little bit of purple on the pink there. Not on the white, I'm sorry, I misspoke. And we're gonna dribble our paintbrush in to give us this striped look. And I'll show you how we do that. Just take your paintbrush and on the flat side, just touch the top of the paint lightly so that it comes up. And then you just wanna stroke downward. See how it makes that nice streak? And we can dab the paint again. And we can stroke downward again and again. And then you just keep going around in a nice smooth circle. You want to make sure you get up here by the stem and keep stroking down and down and down. Make sure you get all the white covered. You want to come down to the bottom, as far down to the bottom as you can. Got a little bit of water in my paintbrush still, so it's leaking a little bit, but that's okay. And we're going to come here and put a little bit more on because we really want this streaked marbled effect. If it starts to blend too much, you can always add more paint. And just keep coming all the way around. like so. Now you can do any kind of decoration that you want. You don't have to do it the way that I've done it. If you want to splatter paint, you could take a toothbrush and dip a toothbrush in paint, and then using your thumb, brush over the bristles so that the paint splatters on top of the pumpkin. That gives it a speckled effect. That's a really cool look. You could also get a stencil and put a stencil over the front of your pumpkin and paint over the stencil. And then you get a shadow on your pumpkin. I've seen that done too. I saw another sample where someone painted their pumpkin black and purple and pink and blue. And then they carved out from the bottom. They cut open the bottom side here and they took everything out from underneath. And then they poked holes all the way around in constellation shapes and made it look like the universe. It was really cool. So there's lots of unique ideas to do with your pumpkin. Now the next thing we're gonna do, you have to let that dry really well. So we're gonna work on the side here that is already dry. And the next thing that I wanna do here is I want to add tissue paper to my pumpkin. And I'm gonna put it on with a little bit of, we're gonna use some pink tissue paper squares. And I've got some hot pink tissue paper squares. There we go. And I'm gonna put it on with a little bit of Mod Podge, which is basically just a sealer, a glossy sealer. And we're gonna put that on, and I'm gonna mix a little bit of glitter in that too. And so we're gonna pour some Mod Podge on my plate. And this stuff does smell kind of strong, so you might wanna do this in a well-ventilated room. And then you can use, I recommend if you can find it, the fine glitter. It seems to work a little bit better than the thicker glitter, but I didn't have white glitter in fine. So we're only gonna add just a little bit of white glitter to our Mod Podge here. We don't want a whole lot. With glitter, a little bit goes an awful long way. So then we're gonna stir this all together so it all gets mixed into the Mod Podge really, 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 really well. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to put one coat on like this. Just real quickly. We kind of want to work fast here because we don't want it to dry before I get time to put my tissue paper samples on. And we'll work in a section here. And now that I've got that section done, now I'm just going to take some tissue paper. And you can either cut it or you can tear it, however you want to do it. And we're just going to lay it on in random places like so. And we'll cover it over with this one too. And you don't have to completely cover it. That's why you've got the purple paint on there too. Give it some contrast and colors, kind of like an abstract kind of way to decorate your painting, your pumpkin. And we're going to come on down here and get more. You can cut out shapes that are circles. You can do rectangles, triangles, squares, stars, hearts, any kind of shapes that you like. I want you to be as creative as you can possibly be. And then come up here, put another little light pink one up there and a hot pink one there like so. And when you think you've got enough on here, oops, they're all sticking to my Mod Podgy fingers. When you think you have enough on, then dip your Mod Podge in again, and this time paint directly on top of the tissue paper. This will seal the tissue paper to your pumpkin and keep it from flaking off. It'll also make it just as shiny as the rest of the pumpkin you just painted. It's kind of like, it works like a glue. And it looks kind of white and foamy right now. Don't worry, that will all dry. Kind of like school glue all dries. And then we're gonna work on another section. And we're gonna put some Mod Podge on this and do this section too, the same way we did that one. And we just keep putting tissue paper stickers on, or tissue paper squares on in any way that we want. They keep sticking to my fingers. And I'll put it like that. You can overlap them a little bit if you want. You can also use more than one color. You don't have to do, I could have done green and oranges if I wanted. I just kind of want to stick with the pink motif. And then again, now we're going to cover these up with the Mod Podge. You can get Mod Podge at just about any store. You can get it at a big box store like Target or Walmart. You can get it at a craft store like Hobby Lobby or Michael's. Most stores will carry Mod Podge. You can also order it online if you don't want to go out shopping right now because of the pandemic. Okay, so here we are, and we're just about to our wet paint section, so we'll have to wait for that section to dry before we can go on with this. We can finish up these squares here, but we'll have to let that section dry before we can put more tissue paper. And we'll just finish this up here. And a little bit down here maybe. And maybe one more down here. Of course, people won't see the bottom of your pumpkin, so you don't have to be as finicky about the bottom as you were maybe on the top. Unless you really want to be. Now, I would let your pumpkin dry for a couple hours here before you touch it and play with it. You want to make sure that this dries really well. And you'll know it's dry completely when it's no longer sticky to touch. And now you can kind of see already where we had put it on earlier. Just kind of smoothing it out a little bit. And when it's all dry, the glitter that we have in there will make it pop out and sparkle. You can kind of see how the light's catching it already. And it'll dry and be nice and smooth. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, well, we're going to pause the video here and let this dry, and then we'll show you how it looks when it's all done. So as you can see, I use my blow dryer to kind of make it dry a little faster. I put it on the colder setting and on low, like that. And then we just kind of air dried it if we were kind of in a hurry. And it gives that really nice, shiny, sparkly effect to it. And when the whole pumpkin is dry, we'll do the rest of the tissue paper and the Mod Podge on the rest of it. And all of the pumpkin will look with that really kind of abstract look of the tissue paper and the paint. I think it turned out really cool and really sharp. So not all Halloween pumpkins need to be orange. You can be as creative and as unique as you want. For example, our beach pumpkin. That was not done with a Halloween. I'm still in the mood for summer. So we went with a beach pumpkin. But like I said, you can come up with anything you'd like. If you don't feel like carving a pumpkin, this is another option for the season. So I hope you enjoyed this craft, boys and girls. We're going to do one more craft, so stay tuned for another video that we're going to do, and we're going to show you how to make the inside out of a jack-o'-lantern. Okay, we'll see you in our next video. Bye!